Alright, this is a 8-foot fan aeromotor windmill. I bought it off a chicken farm. It had been up since the 40s. Needs a lot of work. All the tail spring and all the pieces in the back are all rusted off, but that's why I had a hard time keeping the tail vane back straight. It wants to just follow the slightest breeze. Amazingly enough, there's not a single bullet hole in this thing. Kind of hard to believe for me. I know as a kid, the first thing I would have done is probably shot an old abandoned windmill with a 22. My primary job for today is to get it all taken apart, tailbone and tail vane off it, and that linkage, get the fan broken down, spokes off it.
Now this is the wheel at the front. There's a brake band, just like an old school go-kart brake or even old school car brake. It's actually a binder. And when you furl the windmill, that brake band right here squeezes the windmill and doesn't let it turn in the wind. At the same time, the tail wheel turns 90 degrees and keeps the wind hitting the edge of the blade instead of the front of the blade. So there's not the force to make it spin like when you have it in a bad storm. All this right here is the furling mechanism, and it's in various states of disrepair, but this is the linkage right here that works the brake. This is where the tail bone and the tail vane and the tail spring all connect here. It's all roached out pretty bad. All right, well, I'll try to give you a good what's up of the gearbox here a little closer. You can maybe see what's going on. So this part right here that my hand is on, that's where the windmill, the wheel connects. And when it turns, as it turns it around, it runs a set of gears over here. It gives us a reduction here to this gear. This gear is a crankshaft, and it runs up this rod. Through this center hole is your pump rod that goes down to your pump. So as the wind turns the windmill around, it pulls the pump rod up. And then as the crankshaft goes over, it brings it back down again. And on and on and on and on and on continuously. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take this gearbox all apart, blast the case, blast all these parts in the glass bead cabinet, check it all out, clean everything, get a good coat of paint on them, replace anything that's worn out, or make the parts if we need to. And then we're going to get it all put back together and hopefully get her back in service.
Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed what you saw here today. Be sure to subscribe to my channel and like us on Facebook, please. Somewhere down below here is a link. We've got a lot more really cool stuff coming. Is that right, camera guy? Is there a link down there? Send me a comment. I'll try to get back to you as soon as I can. Click whatever link, click something. See you soon.